Go.
Hello, my name is Monique Powell, and this is my partner,
Lisa Frank.
And we are social workers. We are here to facilitate your all's group. Basically, the purpose of this group is to learn about risk and different peer pressures that you guys have going on in your lives right now as teenagers. And basically, for you to give each other feedback on ways to change these situations. And the first thing I want to do is go over house rules. The first house rule is confidentiality, and basically, whatever we discuss in this group, you do not take outside this group. We want everybody to be as open as possible, and with confidentiality, we can get that.
Another point about the confidentiality thing is that anytime you say to either me or my partner or anybody else in the group that you wish to harm yourself or somebody else, we are bound by law to contact the correct authorities. No pressure in saying that, but I needed to say that because that's the truth, okay? Everybody understand that?
And our next house rule is just to respect one another, and
When we want the group to be on one accord, and because this is y'all group and y'all gonna be giving feedback, at a certain time it might get a little loud where everybody's throwing ideas out there where we can't hear. So at that time I'll hold my hand in the air, and that just means everybody calm down, and then we'll continue right on with the process, okay? All right.
And our last rule is basically whatever you put into this group session is what you're gonna get out of it.
All right. And I got some expectations. We're all gonna participate, okay? So we're going to move right on to the next phase of the group, and I want everybody to go around and introduce themselves and tell a fun fact about themselves. If y'all want me to, I'll go first. My name is Lisa, and a fun fact about me is I like to paint.
My name is Ramon. Fun fact about me is I like to play sports.
My name is Jackie, and the fun fact about me is I like to play volleyball.
My name is Ronald, and fun fact about me is I like to play 2K.
My name is Jennifer, and a fun fact about me is I just like having fun.
My name is Darion. My fun fact is I like to dance high.
My name is
Adrian,
and
my fun fact
is I like to laugh a lot.
Alright. Great facts.
My name is Monique, and I like to play basketball.
Alright, you got a lot of sports fans in here. Okay, now at a certain point in times in the group, you'll see me with this notebook, and what's going to happen is when y'all throw out something that is positive about how to help each other out of that situation, we'll write it down and we might just hand it to you. So at the end of the group, when I check in with y'all at the end of the meeting, y'all could refer back to this. This is one of the things I got out of the group, or you can say something else if you like, but we'll probably turn off and hand it to you just so everybody will know what we came up with. Okay? All right, so let's move on. How about somebody give me a high risk situation and then somebody will talk about how y'all can get out of that situation.
What about if like one of your friends are in a gang and like they did like a robbery and you was with them but you didn't do it? How like would you get out of that situation?
I would probably like try to talk my friend out of it first. Because, you know, I don't want them to go rob a house and get locked up. I would tell them like to walk away and not do it.
Because you're getting in as much trouble as they want, even though you didn't do it, you're still in that situation.
Right. Right.
Anybody
else?
I would ask them nicely to keep my name out of it. I would kindly take my phone in my pocket and make it seem like it was ringing and pick it up and say that my mother asked me to be home on the spot right now.
Alright, that's good. How about any of y'all?
I'll go do the same thing he did.
Okay.
For me, I would have to, automatically reject, but in a way for them to understand the sin, not trying to be like, not trying to be like all forceful and stuff, but at the same time convince them, oh, he's, you know, he's not the type to do nothing about it, but you know, he's not one of them type of people that's going to try to endure it.
I get what you're saying. So you would sternly say, that ain't who I am, and yeah. Please don't approach me like that. I get that. Mm-hmm. Okay, so anybody else got any help? What about, let's talk about, okay, Ryan, go ahead.
Say, for instance, if your friends try to get you to jump into a fight, and during the fight, he pulls out a gun and hands it to you and asks him to shoot the person. I would kindly walk away, tell him and grab him and tell him it doesn't need to happen like this, and this is not what it has to come to. There's no need to take another person's life or something stupid or petty.
I would probably say it's not worth it.
I would probably think that, I ain't trying to be negative, but I think it would be better to at least settle it as men, as, well, whoever it is, being male, female, either way, to settle it one-on-one or whatever, with no introductions, whoever it is, let them settle it. I ain't gonna say they gotta have to fight it out, but they can at least, you know, if they have to fight it out without guns or anything like that, then at least I think it would be better for them to do that, because now in society, most of the people are getting more shot more than just actually selling it like this. Because most of the time that you saving two of your lives, yeah, you might get hurt a little bit, but, you know, you're still both alive, like, you're still breathing. So, it's different from having to deal with another person, so somebody's child being in a grave site.
Right. I agree.
If somebody started talking about behind your back, and you feel like you need to do something about it, but at the same time, you know at the right time that it's not your type of way to have them occur. Like you didn't occur at the moment, but you know people's already gonna do about this. They keep bringing it up.
That's when you have good friends to show the table. Like he's not worth it. You ain't gotta react that way. You ain't gotta let them tell you that you gotta be a certain way.
I feel like you should ignore them the best you can until they touch you, honestly. And then that's when, like, if they kept touching you repeatedly, just, like, pushing you around, bullying you and stuff, I think you would, like, go to the counselor, and if they didn't handle it the right way, I would, like, stick up for myself and do that.
Okay. Any other scenarios?
Family.
Let's talk about family. What about family?
Always standing right there beside them. Never dodge them.
No matter what they put them, never let somebody else put them down, harm them in any way. No matter how close or how mad you are at each other, even friends that you've known for a while and tend to claim as family, never let anybody do anything or any harm to them. Always have their back.
And always be there for them, especially through problems like fights or breakups.
If it's family that you ain't seen in about 20, 25 years, which you still gotta have to bet.
Right, always forget.
Always forget. Yeah. That's good. Okay, we're coming to a close of my meeting. But I wanted to ask about one more scenario, if y'all don't mind. Let's talk about safe sex. How about if maybe you and Darion was together, or you and Jackie was together, and y'all had the urge to participate, but nobody had any protection. How would you talk the other friend out of participating in that act?
I would say make sure, please, I don't know if people, kids be saying it's not right to tell your parents what they do, but it would be better for them to, first you want to make sure your partner's straight. Period, point blank. Because that's going to be decide everything. And second of all, go back to your peoples, you know, because you ain't no telling. Most likely, y'all going to try to do it while you're not there, or if they even if they are there, some people try to do it. It's you gotta, you know, and get advice. It's always about if they if you have their support about it. Especially like if it's a virgin type thing, virgin to virgin. Oh, I don't care. What is it? You know, it's always gotta have another thought of yours, a second thought for you to go back to if the first one doesn't count.
Okay. Anybody
else? If the person that needs to interact doesn't have any, or I don't have any, then I'll try to find the closest store that sells.
No.
If I wanted to participate, if you did want to participate and you had that urge, I would try to find the right store to go get the protection from.
So why do you disagree?
I mean, if they don't have it, then he's like coming straight up. Like I would tell Jackie, like he does not have any protection. Like don't wait around, cause I mean, I don't know.
I mean, ultimately, that's her choice. But
yeah, that is her choice. But at the same time, I feel like if you don't have protection, then don't do it.
And
cause you won't try to.
Also, I feel like if you didn't have protection, you're just like only there for that one thing. You're not there to stay and like build with them. And you shouldn't do that to either a female or a boy. You shouldn't like just like leave it. And like get what you want and then leave it for that. You should like build with them.
Okay.
And if you don't have protection, then God is telling you that it's not meant to happen, so you walk away or wait for God to tell you that you did say okay to do it and it's a go. Or say for instance, only do it with somebody you truly trust and you truly love and who you really want to spend the rest of your life with. Or who you want to be with for a while and long-term goals and relationships.
Okay, so we're coming to a close, I mean. But before we close, I want to say on that say sex issue, trust them, love them, but have condoms, okay?
Yes.
Don't do it without a condom. Don't do it.
And although you have to have your guard up too.
Yeah. Just don't do what I have, ever. Okay? Okay, listen. What I think I heard out of our group, I felt like it was a really good group. What I thought I heard was always check your thinking about the situation. I heard Darian talk about thinking about some stuff before you do it, putting it into context about really where you're at with the situation, having two people talk it out. I heard that, and it was really good. I heard a lot about positive self-talk, lifting people up, encouraging them, motivating them to get out of that situation. Did you want to input anything about that?
And I also heard just basically forgive, like what you said, forgive, and always be there for your family because they definitely have your back. And thank you guys for participating.
Yeah. So now I'm going to just go do a quick check-in and ask each one of y'all. Y'all can go around and tell me how y'all felt about the group and what was one thing you really want to hold on to about the group. You start, right?
Well, one thing that I felt that was positive about the group was that we talked about how we could get out of high-risk situations, not knowing, even if you didn't know how to conduct yourself or conduct yourself when a scenario like that's proposed to you, then you know how to conduct yourself in a way that's positive. You and that person out of there safely. And
okay.
The positive thing that I learned from this group is like you can't always do things. You have to think before you do it. And if you know what you're doing, you're gonna have to face the consequences because you knew you was doing it and it's the wrong thing to do.
Thing I've learned is never let anybody talk your friend, family, or girlfriend or anybody you really care about down in any type of way and always be able to speak up for that person.
One thing that I learned is to forgive. Like she said, not to get up hurt, but my sister had an addiction and like the only way I could like get our bond back together is to forgive her. So I feel like forgiveness is really big key.
I would say that I learned to believe in others more than just myself and have trust.
Okay. I feel like I learned like in real life like how to react to like real life like scenarios.
Alright. Well, thank y'all. for participating. And at any time, if y'all ever want to get together and have another group where y'all talk, y'all can contact me. I'm my partner, and we can sit down and do that. If y'all have any concerns or questions, y'all can ask us on one-on-one after the group. But it was great meeting y'all. I think y'all are a great group of kids. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Kill it.